Get ready to match the stars from Proper John, Charles Siebert, Fred Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly from Vegas, Philistine, Morgan Mindy, Robert Donner, and Marcia Wallace as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Raymond.
Shall we have a go at it?
Great.
Why not?
Thank you very much. All ready?
Yes.
All right. Well, over here we have Karen Bridge and Fred Womack.
Yay!
Now, just to refresh our memories, Karen, tell us about yourself again.
I'm a secretary. I'm working for a publishing company. I'm a native Californian, and in my spare time, I play tennis.
All right, sir. And Fred?
I'm from San Diego. I'm soon to be transferred to Northern California by my company. I officiate sports. Like to ski,
yep.
Marry, and have two sons.
All right. Now, we've played one game, which Fred won, and he won $500, but he kind of stubbed his toe when he went for the big money. We are in game number two now, in the middle of round one, and it's Fred's turn, and we have this question for him. Little Rodney Rotten is really rotten.
Yeah.
Here it is. Today, he taught his dog to roll over. He did it by putting it in a blank. Listen, on your show, Trapper John,
yes.
Do you play one of the original guys, one of the original doctors who's in...
In Korea?
Korea?
No.
No.
I play Dr. Stanley Riverside II, M.D., resident jerk.
Ah. Gotcha. But I love it. Little Rodney Rotten is really rotten, Fred. Today he taught his dog to roll over. He did it by putting it in a blank.
Real rotten. Fire.
Fred.
Betty White's gonna get you.
I must say, we do have a matched pair up here, don't we?
A fire.
That's cruelty to animals.
Washing machine. You understand now?
Oh. Fire,
yes.
Huh?
Yes, fire.
Watching machine.
Yes. Hey.
Watching machine.
There'll be no
watching
fire here.
Watching machine.
I can guarantee you there'll be no fire here.
Don't be so sure.
Aha.
Little plug there.
I love that tie and collar.
Thank you.
You know who wears collars like that? And it's a beautiful collar. Anwar Sadat. He really...
Snappy dresser.
Oh, he's a wonderful dresser.
Yeah,
he wears those Duke of Windsor collars.
This was made for me by Mr. Seymour of Redondo Beach. He does all... I don't need the fake laugh. So obvious.
Very handsome, Charles.
Yes.
Thank you.
Now, Miss Phyllis, Rodney Rotten taught his dog to roll over. He did it by putting it in a...
Putting it in a dryer.
That would be a circular motion, make it roll over. What do you say?
Fred, I applaud your answer, because it takes the heat off me. A dryer.
A laundry dryer.
Oh. What'd you say, Marsh?
Huh?
What'd you say?
Come up with something?
What'd you say, Marsh?
You know, let's talk more about that Anwar Sadat.
Let's talk more.
I'm a nice guy. Maybe we could get him for the panel here.
We could.
Right,
I'd love to have Anwar Sadat.
See
if you can book him.
Book Anwar Sadat. Now, see, I told you I was out of show business and I can't think anymore.
You used to be fat, too, weren't you?
I did.
Yes.
Tell him about that. That should take an hour and a half. What did you?
Knock it off.
You sure know how to make
What did you weigh?
I weighed 230 pounds, hon. I lost an entire person and my personality and my attention span. Charles knew me when I was a chubette.
Really?
Uh-huh.
What? Did you work together?
We worked together down on Wall Street in a fabulous CBS TV movie. That's about it
Sounds
for
like
that.
Sounds like stalling.
Tell me about your hometown now.
Oh, hey, the time I followed the cow?
You going to show us your answer?
Oh, I suppose. Water pick. Now, I just put it down because I can't see it.
I must say, water pick is a perfectly dreadful answer.
Well, but, don't hang back, Gene. Tell me how you feel about it.
But I also must say that rarely does Marcia draw a blank and come up with a rotten answer, because she's a wonderful game player and a good kisser, too.
Oh. Mm. I am really steamed.
What are you steamed about?
Just, what is does that mean? What about me sitting up here year after year after day?
You get yours after the show.
Boy, oh boy.
All right, here we go. Oh, it's a scoreless tie. Now, when we have a tie like that, since Karen won first last time, Fred, you go first this time.
B.
All right. Get the tiebreaker question ready. Sloppy Sam is so sloppy. After he eats, not only does he have to lick his fingers, he has to lick his blank. All right, Karen. Sloppy Sam is so sloppy. No? Oh, it's you.
And you're being on the contestants.
I'm glad somebody understands what's going on here, because I don't. Sloppy Sam is so sloppy, after he eats, not only does he have to lick his fingers, he has to lick his blank.
Toes.
Yeah. Toes. Yeah. Toes. Some people enjoy that.
Yes, yes. Getting into the realm of Mondo Grosso here.
Face. Face. All right.
Okay. He has to lick his entire chest, down to and including, get ready for it, folks, his navel.
Oh.
I said his wife and other dinner guests.
He too much.
See, you don't need the fake laughter.
Yeah. Not after you slap. Hey. Wow.
Oh, we just had a light blow.
A light
another
blew
Tim
out there.
Conway cheap light okay. Just went.
You all right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes.
Don't stop now. Okay. We're rolling.
All right.
I knew I could hit high notes, but gee whiz.
Boy, I knew the show was bad, but this is ridiculous. Sloppy Sam. Not only does he have to lick his fingers, he has to lick his blank.
His chest.
Chest. Well. All right.
I wish the lights had gone out now.
Shirt. It's a shirt, Robert. All right.
All right. Now, I have not had a date in so long that this does not sound all that unpleasant to me. Toes.
Toes. Hosanna, Hosanna. We finally got one match here. Now, Karen, you will have the difficult task when we return matching one to tie or two to win. Now, that's not too hard, is it, Karen? Now, watch this message, if you please. Thank you. All right, here we go. Now, ready? All right, this is your... Listen carefully now.
Okay.
It's very important to Karen. Henry said, my wife is a compulsive cheater. She even cheated on a blank test.
Now, well, you can't take it up too hard, dear, because...
Henry said, my wife is a compulsive cheater. She even cheated on a blank test. you want to read it aloud to you once yourself? No. Take a deep breath, relax. I know you're a little bit nervous, but we want you to feel at ease and give us your best shot here.
Okay. Driving test?
Leave the woman alone.
A little sympathy.
I guess, Karen, it's been splendid meeting you. Send a lot of gifts your way for match game.
Excuse me. If you don't get to me, if she wins and you don't get to me, I want you to look at my answer because it's really wonderful and I really...
Well, now, wait a minute. We can reverse
start
the whole thing and start with you.
Oh, we
go
can?
This way and go up that way.
Oh, what a treat.
Yeah, we go both ways here. This way.
I know. Include me out.
Right. I had thought so, honey.
All right.
Okay, set it up.
Henry said, my wife is a compulsive cheater. She even cheated on a blank test.
Pregnancy. Yeah. Hey.
Everybody has that answer.
Well,
We'll have to get the Kleenex out again because I know you're going to weep when everybody else says answer. Pregnancy test there.
Well,
say pregnancy test.
Pregnancy test.
Thank you. Say pregnancy test.
It's a rabbit test.
Well, wait a minute.
Oh, a rabbit test. No, we got to get
the... You're asking for answers?
Yes.
I thought you were asking for brains.
Oh, I see. And show us yours.
Karen, I've looked at you for 2 days. Those pleading eyes, and God knows I've tried to help. But, you know, you got to give better answers than driving tests. Uh-huh.
I told you, get the tiebreaker questions ready. All right, Miss Phyllis.
Well, mine was rabbit.
You said rabbit.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that would be, that's a pregnancy test.
Oh, it's not quite.
Got?
Wanna buy a new light for your show?
All right.
These are $2.
Yeah, all right. Can I owe it to you? I don't
Return
have it.
Return to Tim Conway in the morning.
Thank you very much. That's kind of you. All right. Now, may we see your answer, please?
Yes.
Yes.
That tie and shirt doesn't quite make it, does it? I said rabbit.
Tie and shirt is perfect. Rabbit, yes.
I love your tie. I love your shirt.
It's a very snappy
outfit. I love your little hanky.
It's sharp. It looks sharp.
Yeah. Yes. You know where this came from?
Where?
It's a great shop in Boston called Louis, and he's got nothing but feel the quality of that.
It's a great shop.
Oh, sure.
Big Louis.
Feel my silk.
Sure, the old there. The old
who
feel
shot
my
the bulb
silk
out.
Group.
Big
right,
Louis.
That's right. What do you got there?
That's what the bishop said to the actress. Feel my silk. Well, Marcia, you had a little lapse there, hon.
Well, it won't be my first of the day, was it?
Rabbit.
Oh, well. Rabbit.
Everybody seems to be saying that. Charles, did you have the temerity to say rabbit test?
I had not the temerity. I don't even know if they have these anymore. This is what you have to pass if you want to work for Universal, the Wasserman test.
Aha! That's a little play on words there, because they've got a guy named Lou Wasserman, who's head of the company. And Wasserman is also a blood test you take before you get married.
Gene, we know
that. I have this tumor growing here on my side. I hope to have it removed sometime in the near future. A little simple surgery will do it. All right, where are we? 1-1, a tie. Heavens to Betsy. Now we push the tie button here. One tiebreaker question for each. The one who matches most will be the winner. Karen, you go first.
A.
A. Now she's there. She's got that figured out. Did you hear that pointy-headed Paul died?
No.
Pointy-headed Paul died. Paul was so pointy-headed, they didn't bury him. Instead, they turned him upside down and blanked him into the ground. I'm glad you found that amusing.
You really in love with that bulb, aren't you, baby?
Yes.
Getting way too attached, aren't you?
Beautiful bulb. Karen, did you hear that pointy-headed Paul died? Let me tell you about it. Pointy-headed Paul was so pointy-headed, they didn't bury him. Instead, they turned him upside down and blanked him into the ground.
Screwed?
Screwed him into the ground. When she finally gets the idea, she really goes, doesn't she?
She spoke right up for that one.
Right, she sure did, yes.
Screwed.
Screwed. All right, there's one.
Well, I sort of didn't say that.
You didn't?
No, you know me, dear. I said nailed or pounded with a hammer.
Yes, well, that's another thing you do with a pointy thing there. You know, hammered into the ground or screwed into the ground.
I said hammered or pounded.
All right. Those are the two good responses. Hammered or pounded or screwed. They're both excellent responses there. Thanks. Phyllis, what do you say?
I put hammered.
You put hammered, eh?
Here's another excellent response, hammered.
Hammered, yes, of course.
From one of my favorite songs in the 60s, Peter, Paul, and Mary's,
yes.
If I Had a Screw.
Right. That's true for her. Now, Fred, you need 2 to tie and 3 to win, and this is yours. Sheila said that piano tuner is strange. He took out his tuning fork and started blanking my piano. Would you you like to hold my light bulb for a while? Okay.
I'd like to, Gene.
Oh. You have to be very gentle.
Oh, I am.
All right. I have to have it back in a little while. Don't hurt it.
You light my bulb.
I want to eat with the other patients.
Ready, Robert? There we go. Sheila said that piano tuner is strange. He took out his tuning fork and started blanking my piano.
Eating.
Yeah. Eating. What'd you say?
I'm getting so good at this eating.
Yeah, you got the hang of it. There's one. 2-1 the score. Brett?
Come on, a little peanut butter on the keys. It's fabulous.
Tie score right now. 2-2. And Charles.
I'm sorry, eating.
Eating, that wins the game. What the lowest here have? Hold him up, please. Eating. Playing the Italian national anthem. All right, I'll get that cord out of your way. And Karen, we have to say goodbye to you. We're going to send wonderful prizes to you. The Encyclopedia Britannica, which you can study up on for your next appearance on this program. Karen Lynch, there she goes. Now a little message for America. Here we go with Fred, and go at the big money. Fred, we polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. She's too blank for me. 500 for matching the most popular, 250 for the second, and 100 for the third. Whom do you want to call on? The lady with the light bulb over her head, perhaps?
Marcia.
Oh!
She has an idea. On? That's what that means.
That's what it means. Thank you, Gene.
Right.
Sorry you had to explain that one, honey. Sure, Charles got the big laugh at the bulb. Now I'm stuck with it for the rest of the show.
No, if you don't like my light bulb,
I'll take it back.
Yes.
It's pretty clammy now.
Come on, baby, light my bulb.
She's too fat for me.
All right, that was a song of yesteryear. Brett.
She's too hot for me.
Uh-huh.
Charles.
She's too old for me.
So he said, she's too old for me, she's too hot for me, and she's too fat for me. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own.
I think it's fat.
Old.
Old.
Oh. I don't think so.
I guess he's too young to remember that song of some years ago. She's too fat for me.
I can have her uterus.
Yeah, that's it. Let's see what we got under the $100 response. She's too good for me. The 250 says, she's too old for me. You got it there. And up on top, we've got fat. There it is. Now, Fred, you've won $250, means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $2,500. But we want you to step up here and spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and play for $5,000. We'll all root for a double. Here we go. For $2,500. Here we go. No help from the audience, if you please. Blank kick. K-I-C-K. Blank kick. K-I-C-K.
K-I-C-K?
Mm-hmm. Here, I'll bring it over there so you can see
I'm
the word.
I'm sorry. I thought you said K-I-T. I'm sorry.
K-I-C-K is what I said.
I'm terribly sorry, Josh.
All right. Now, she's ready, Fred. If you give us the answer that she has on the card, we give you $2,500. Nothing to it.
Foot kick. I have no idea.
No idea. No idea. All right. Let's find out what Brett has. Brett, what have you got?
Well, I think we would have been better off with the kick because we all would have said first aid. I said high kick.
High kick. What else is there, John? What
would it drop happen? Kick.
Free kick.
I don't know anything about kick. Football, yeah. So don't get into that with me.
Place kick. That's right. And the side
Swift
kick.
Kick.
Yeah.
Side
soccer kick.
Too many
Swift
choices.
Kick. Well, listen, Fred, kick. You got a total of $750 and our best wishes. Many thanks for being here. And now we've got this for you.
When after we're off, we're going to form a giant pyramid here and screw in the light bulb that blew out a little while ago.
All right. Who's on the bottom?
You can be sure if it's Westing.
All right, I'll be on the bottom. You get on top of me then. Come on, Simmons.
Today's consolation prizes are a 7-piece Performer Gourmet cutlery set with extra sharp chrome stainless steel blades, ebony Fleetwood handles, dishwasher safe from Washington Forge, an Amcor Fresh and Air electronic air ionizer, and smoke, odors, dust, pollen, bacteria in your automobile. Fresh and Air for fresher air everywhere. And a walk in La Choy Chinese food. Let your meals swing American with La Choy bean sprouts, vegetables, water chestnuts, bamboo shoots, and soy sauce. And a Betty Crocker cookbook can make someone happy with new improved Super Moist, now even better than before. Other cakes may be moist, but they're not super moist. And a honey dish and pure sous vide honey. No synthetic or artificial ingredients. You haven't tried honey, but you tried the natural goodness of sous vide honey. And a baby bath and changing pad plus diaperine baby washcloths, moisture-packed towelettes or lanolin, a clean and conditioned. Keep your baby better than clean with diaperine. And a pen and pencil set and liver snacks, treats for dogs with real liver. No wonder dogs really love them. Liver snacks. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.